My connection into the technology world of diabetes started pretty quickly after my diagnosis. I got put on a continuous glucose monitor, I got put on an insulin pump, and when I realized I had this incredible data stream from an insulin pump and this incredible data stream from a CGM, and that there was no software out there that brought that data together, I was absolutely floored. So I started hacking my own software solutions together, and that actually caught on and people started asking me for it. But I couldn't give them a version of my software because I didn't have access to their device data, and I was not nearly comfortable enough hacking into their devices for them. I was kind of at a crossroads.
So here we are living in Palo Alto. Literally, Steve Jobs' kids went to the same elementary school as my kids, right? We're in the heart of Silicon Valley. I'm a VP of software, and I can't make the software work that would help my daughter and help us give insights into her data. The data was locked in these proprietary silos, none of the devices worked together, and there were these vendor lock-in on both ends of the equation. And I remember just shaking my fist, going, "Ah, why doesn't somebody do something about this?" Oh, wait, that could be me.
When Howard came back to me with this idea for an interoperable data platform where people could upload their devices no matter what device maker it came from, I stopped what I was doing, moved out to California to help Howard start Tidepool.
Tidepool is a nonprofit organization. We make diabetes software. Our mission is to make diabetes data more meaningful, accessible, and actionable for people with diabetes, their care teams, and clinicians. We also support diabetes research, which means, in my perspective, we cover the entire spectrum of the diabetes experience.
We started with kind of humble beginnings of exporting data from other software and pulling it into Tidepool. Then we built the Tidepool Uploader that is now one product that supports just about every insulin pump and continuous glucose monitor out there, as well as a whole bunch of the most popular blood glucose meters. And you can use this one piece of software, whether you're a clinician or a person at home, to get your data into a secure cloud. It's now adapted to smartphones, so you can actually upload data directly from your iPhone and then see all your data in one place at one time, either on the web or on a mobile app for iPhone or Android.
That's the accessible portion of the mission, where the data gets into the Tidepool platform. And we're going to make your data actionable through Tidepool Loop. You have all this data, we're going to put it to good work.
With Tidepool Loop, I'm most excited that we're going to be able to bring the DIY loop experience to people who don't necessarily feel qualified to build it for themselves.
The Tidepool Loop project is an effort to take what the DIY Loop community has had and turn it into an FDA-regulated app that you can download from the App Store that is plug and play with different devices.
To be able to offer it to people who would not otherwise be able to use a DIY solution, I think it's amazing.
There's a whole bunch of people that just aren't comfortable using a product that isn't supported by a company or hasn't been brought to the FDA through the regulatory process. So I'm excited that we're gonna solve all of those problems. We are bringing it to the FDA and we're making Loop work with supported in-warranty insulin pumps and continuous glucose monitors. We are only able to do this because of all the incredible work that has gone before us, all the people that have made DIY Loop an incredible success.
For so long, my diabetes management has been dependent on me to count the carbs, figure out the insulin, check my blood sugar, do all that manually. Handing as much of that over to an algorithm, to a piece of software that is designed to do this effectively and safely, that's the thing that I'm most excited to engage in with.
One of the things that was really important to me was finding people who shared that same sense of purpose and mission as I did. And so it was just natural that the first wave of employees that I hired all had a personal connection to type 1 diabetes.
It became more than just a team or a bunch of colleagues. It was our own little community, our own little family. As the team has grown and evolved, that dynamic has not changed. We're now more than 30 people, and it still has that same feeling of we are in this together, not because this is a job that we want to come into, but because we have Pancreas in the game, and we have to get this fixed.